For the equation of each parabola, that's a function, all of these parabolas are going to go up or down. We're going to state whether it opens upward or downward. State the equation of the axis of symmetry, the vertex point, and the y-intercept. Number one. Now, it's good if you could try this on your own first. All right, let's see. Does it go up or down? Well, the coefficient of x squared is positive, so it goes up. How about the axis of symmetry? There's two ways to get the axis of symmetry. You could use the formula x equals negative b over 2a, or you could remember if there is no x term, the axis of symmetry is x equals 0, okay? Or if it was in this form, y equals x minus h squared plus k, you take what's in here and you solve, you make it equal to 0, so that would mean x equals h. In any case, the axis of symmetry is x equals 0. So to get the vertex, you plug that number in for the x coordinate and solve for y. So if you put in 0 for x, y is negative 5. Notice that's the same thing as the y-intercept on this problem, because if you put in 0 for x, you get negative 5. So that's number 1. Okay, try this one on your own by putting the video on pause and then trying it. All right, let's go. All right, the coefficient this time is negative 2, so a is negative 2, so this one goes down. Okay? Axis of symmetry, it's easy to pick out this time because if you take x minus 3 and set it equal to 0, that gives you that equation, x equals 3. So the axis of symmetry, the equation of that is x equals 3, and that's the number that goes in here for the vertex. But if it's in this form, this number over here will be the y value, 7. If you forget that, remember, you just plug in 3 for x into this equation, and when you do plug in 3 for x right here, that'll give you a negative 2 times 0, so you're still going to get 0 plus 7, or 7 for the y value. All right, what about the y-intercept? You put in 0 for x, so we're going to take that equation, negative 2 x minus 3 squared plus 7. Remember, you're looking for the y value when you plug in 0 for x. Well, if you put a 0 for x, that's just a negative 3 squared plus 7, negative 2 times 9 plus 7, and that gives you negative 11. So the y-intercept here would be 0, negative 11. This will help you if you graph the vertex point and the y-intercept, you know there's a point on the other side of the axis of symmetry. So that's, you'll find the other y-intercept. All right, how about this one? Y equals negative x squared plus x plus 2. All right, the coefficient of x squared is negative, so this one has to go down. And this is not in the form where it's easy to tell what the axis of symmetry is, so let's use the formula x equals negative b over 2a. Remember, all you need to know are the coefficients of a and b, the coefficients of x squared and x to get the a and the b. So I have minus, what's b? The coefficient of x is 1, and a, the coefficient of x squared is negative 1, so I have 1 half if you reduce that. So the axis of symmetry is the line x equals 1 half. Now to get the vertex point, you need to put in 1 half into that equation. So we'll take that equation, y equals negative x squared plus x plus 2, plug in 1 half for x. The minus sign is not being squared, just the 1 half. Okay, so that's negative 1 fourth, and I can see I'm going to have to get a common denominator of fourths, so I'm going to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2 to get 2 fourths. And the number 2 I'm going to multiply by 4 over 4 to get 8 fourths. So I have a common denominator, and that's going to give you 10 minus 1, or 9 fourths. So when you put in 1 half for x, right, that's what you're doing, the same number here, you got 9 fourths for the y value. The y-intercept is easy to plug into this problem. You put in 0 for x, and you just get the number 2. So 0, 2 is the y-intercept. Next problem. All right. Again, always feel free to put it on pause and try it on your own first. Does this go up or down? Well, the coefficient of x squared is positive, so that means it goes up. Again, axis of symmetry, not clear. Let's use the formula, x equals negative b over 2a. So we have negative, all right, what's b? B is the coefficient of x, that's negative 4, over 2a, 2 times 2. So if I reduce that, you get 4 fourths or 1. So the axis of symmetry is the equation, x equals 1. I mean, it's the line that has that equation. So for the vertex point, you're going to put in 1 for x. So now we go up back to the original problem, and if you put in 1 for x, you would get y equals, or in this case, f of 1, if you want to think of in terms of what's f of 1, it's going to be 2 minus 4 plus 1, because when you put in 1 for the x squared of the x, it's just going to be 1. So that's going to be negative 1. So when you put in 1, the y value is negative 1, so that's your vertex point. What's your y-intercept? Put in 0 for x. Well, if you put in 0 for x, you get that number over there. 0, 1 is your y-intercept. Keep in mind why this would be helpful, by the way. Why is it nice to know all this stuff? Because you know that the axis of symmetry is here at x equals 1. You know this is going up. And so let's say that's where your vertex point is. You have 1, negative 1. 0, 1 would be your y-intercept. So if this is 1, negative 1, you know, this would be your, let's say that would be your x-axis, and that would be your y-axis. So you know that 0, 1 is here. You know that there's this other point on, oops, I did not do that right. We have 0, 1 right here. Here we go. You know there's a point right on the other side. So that's the convenience. If you have the y-intercept, easy to find another point on the other side of the axis of symmetry if the axis of symmetry isn't the y-axis itself. Okay, next problem. Again, try it on your own first. All right, the coefficient of x squared is 1/2, which is positive, so this goes up. The axis of symmetry, well, there's no x term. When there's no x term, it's just x equals 0. Or if you want, you could always plug it in that formula, x equals negative b over 2a, and of course you'll get 0 again. So the vertex, if you put in 0 for x, you'll just get 11. If there's no x term, then that will always be the y value for the vertex point. What's the y-intercept? Same thing. Put in 0 for x, you have 0, 11. So the vertex and the y-intercept happen to be the same thing. All right, number 6. All right, does it go up or down? Well, the coefficient of x squared is negative 1/2. So since it's negative, it goes down. To get the axis of symmetry, well, let's use the formula x equals negative b over 2a. So what's b in this case? B is the coefficient of x, so we have negative, and then we have a negative 2 for b, and then we have 2 times a. A is negative 1/2. Don't worry about the fractions. So I have this negative and another negative, so that's going to be a positive 2 in the numerator, and 2 times negative 1/2 is negative 1. So 2 divided by negative 1/2 divided by negative 1 is simply 2. So x equals 2 is the equation of the line that's the axis of symmetry, which means for the vertex point, we're going to plug in 2 for x into the original equation up here to figure out what f of x is or what y is. So in other words, f of, actually this was negative 2, forgot to put the minus sign, f of negative 2 would be, all right, let's do this in our head. What's a negative 2 times a negative 2? 4. Minus 2 times negative 2 plus 6. So negative 1/2 times 4 is a negative 2 plus 4 plus 6. So that gives us 8. So the vertex point is negative 2, 8. So that gives us our y value, right? I'm going to change that to blue so it's sort of kind of together. And what about the y-intercept? Well, the y-intercept is what happens when you put in 0 for x, and in that case it's just going to be that last number. You're putting in zeros here, so the y-intercept is 0, 6. So there we've got it for the last problem. It goes down, axis of symmetry, the vertex, and the y-intercept.